profane alternate lyrics to my ballads. Absolutely disgusting. But now I wish I could remember some of them.
The paperwork that man created for me. I had to build a chest just for his violations. A big one.
I taught him 20 different ways to cold forge a bolster. Once, he taught me a slightly easier method of wire pulling, and from that day on called me his apprentice.
A true asshole he was. Gods, I'm gonna miss him.
Aye. Y'all made it. Just about to send him off.
I have met many on my travels. You are one of the few I would call friend.
I always thought you were one of the dumbest creatures I'd ever met. Didn't expect you to be the bravest, too.
This world is a darker place for your leaving it.
We're taking him to the Sverd Sands. It's, in the wetlands near the ferry. We'll wait for you there.
Changed. Sewn some mourning garb. We're not dressed properly.
We're fine. The dwarves don't typically require formal wear at funerals.
Rock certainly would not.
Perhaps.
So, now you've got me thinking of what I might look like with some jewelry around my neck stump. Maybe some gold woven into my beard. That'd be quite fetching, eh?
Thanks for trying.
There they are, brother.
Oh, come on, surely he'll be along. It's his brother.
Let's hope so. Loss can do things to a man. You made it. We can begin.
Thank you.
Sindri. Blackpuss.
It's bigger, the more you take away.
To all things housed in her silence, nature offers a violence. The bear that keeps to his own line, the wolf that seeks always its own. Hardens as the harsher winter holds, the parent forced to eat its young before it grows. Every bird gone unheard, starving where the ground is froze. The winter sunrise, red on white, like blood upon the snow.
Oh, creature offers a violent.
Forgive Sindri, he's just, I mean, you know.
I wrote that dirge for him.
What's it called?
Something profane.
He wouldn't have it any other way.
I don't know if there's anything beyond the life, afterlives after afterlives or whatever you, but if there is, I imagine he's causing one crazy ruckus there.
Spoke of your brother's sword. How did Odin acquire it?
I'll answer this one. Odin disguised himself as the most beautiful person Freyr had ever seen.
This separated Freyr from his sword.
Oh, with embarrassing speed.
I am glad Freyr ultimately retrieved it.
Me too. My little friend.
Circling back to the topic of prophecies brought about by the efforts to avoid them, I think I can recall such a story as you mentioned, brother. A Greek tale for the stage. Rather lurid, but very popular. You know the one?
Every Greek knows the tragedy of the Theban king.
Yeah, word gets around about that sort of thing.
Him. Oh, fast! You got this!
Careful, brother! You're covered in Bifrost!
I just had a thought. With Asgard... destroyed. Where will the Einar Jarl go?
Valhalla exists both inside and outside of Asgard. Who knows what became of it?
Aye. Suppose they'll have to find rest somewhere. Something else I recall about that Greek play I mentioned, if you won't take offense at a critique. As a work of performance, it consisted almost entirely of watching people give speeches and receive terrible news. Might have been nice to see more events dramatized instead of described.
It is Greek tradition for a story to unfold in a single time and place uninterrupted. It is more clear.
If you say so.
Mimir, I never asked how it felt to lose your head.
What would you have me say? That it tickled?
Merely curious.
If you wish to derive some satisfaction from my pain, I'm afraid you'll be disappointed. Kratos swung swift and true, didn't you, brother? I felt nary a scratch.
Shame.